Our Heavenly Father, we are thankful for this beautiful day in Colorado, for this wonderful gathering, and for this opportunity to again pay honor to the 12 Lakewood High School graduates who gave their lives for freedom in World War II. As we rededicate the memorial to those individuals, let us appreciate the significance of this Memorial Day weekend, and let us honor all veterans who have made the ultimate sacrifice for our country. We are grateful for the young people of our country, including the Boy Scouts here, such as Austin Reynolds, who represent the great hope of our citizens for the future of our country and our world. Help them to always be positive citizens, dedicated to helping others and to being the best that they can. This we ask in your name. Amen. Amen. And I would like to bring up Austin Reynolds at this point in time. And here he is. This is the gentleman who spearheaded this project as part of his Eagle Scout.
So I'd like to say a few words in honor of this rededication. So first I have a little poem to read, kind of about the memorial and Memorial Day. It's titled, In Loving Memory. On every soldier's tombstone should be a message of honor, respect, and love. In loving memory of one who loved his country, who fought against evil to preserve what is right and true and good. In loving memory of one who is a cut above the rest of us, who had the surpassing courage, the uncommon strength, to do whatever had to be done, persevering through hardship and pain. In loving memory of one who was brave enough to give his life, his all, so that those he cared about would remain safe and free. In loving memory of a unique and treasured soldier who will never be forgotten. I'd also like to take this point at the rededication, the finalization of my Eagle project, to thank everyone who helped out and sponsored my Eagle project, and basically carried the project forward to where it is today. I'd like to personally thank all of those who gave their time and resources now. American Legion Post 178 of Lakewood, Bedrock Landscaping Materials, the Colorado Emerald Society Pipe Band, Graph Engineering, Harlan Watkins, Home Depot, James Nursery, Landscape Architect Jeff Lormand, Jim Barenberg, Joanne Ardwell, Lakewood Elks Lodge 1777, New Age String Ensemble, Norman's Memorials, the Kiwanis Club of Golden, the Tree Farm, Tom Keller, and VFW Post 4171 Golden. In addition, I'd like to give a special thanks to the following people and organizations for all that they have done to help me on my journey to Eagle. The Lakewood High School Principal, Lisa Ritchie, Lakewood Elks Veterans Committee, Pete Roybal, Lakewood City Councilman, and Troop 130 Scoutmaster Nate Graff, and most importantly, all of the parents and scouts of Troop 130, especially my own. I could not have done it without your support, and I am very grateful. Thank you very much.
Austin, would you come up here, please? This is Carrie Mish, our ER from Lakewood Elks. And I am Vanita Collier, chairman of the Americanism Essay Contest and the Americanism. We were given a flag to give to an outstanding citizen for Americanism. Lakewood Elks has chosen Austin Reynolds to get this flag because of his sincere hard work, dedication, integrity to continuously work toward this project in honoring these World War II veterans who gave up their life and served in World War II. There is no veteran out there that we can thank enough, because we wouldn't be standing up here with freedom if it wasn't for you guys and you women. So Austin, Carrie, would you give him a flag, please?
John, are you?
Good morning. My name is Pete Roybal,
I'm a city councilor here in the city of Lakewood. I'm also a veteran, so I'm very proud. And I'm tearful right now, and I'm so proud that we relocated this memorial. I'm going to talk a little bit about Tom. Tom graduated from California State University at Los Angeles with his bachelor's degree and graduated studies in social studies or social science. He is a Korean War veteran, has served in the United States Army. Tom landed in Incheon and spent most of his time to Busan, Korea. Over the years, his interest in military has grown to where his pride himself as a military historian and a professional speaker. Tom is a founder of the Tuba section leader in the John Philip Sosa American Legion Band of Colorado and has also played in the VFW band. He is a lifetime member of the VFW American Legion 40 and 8 Korean War Veterans Association and the Department of Defense Korean War 60th Anniversary Commemorative Community Committee. He's also a member of the Board of Directors of the Lakewood Historic Society. Tom, can you help me here?
Thank you, buddy. God helps them that helps themselves. It's a pleasure to be here. Good morning to everyone. Again, my name is Tom Keller. I've been a speaker for many, many years, musician, live in Lakewood up in Green Mountain, and very, very proud of the fact of being here today. You should be very proud also with the fact that we're celebrating two holidays today. We're about celebrating the memorial for today. We're also celebrating Memorial Day, which is coming up in Monday. I thought I'd take a few minutes and explain to you a little bit about Memorial Day and what it means to me and what it should mean to you. Memorial Day has come to mean the beginning of summer, a time of picnic and barbecues and a holiday to gather around the family. That happiness and freedom, however, is a product of a real cause for the holiday and the sacrifice made by men and women who have fought and died for the freedom and the liberties America holds dear. Memorial Day is a time to remember that the American way of life is not cheap, that rather has been purchased by the lives and blood of so many who have sacrificed for us to live free and happy now. To many, Memorial Day, a U.S. holiday that takes place every year on the last Monday of May, is just another excuse for a three-day weekend. It's also known as a day that marks the official start of summer and is a day devoted to great, great deals at the mall. However, the true meaning of Memorial Day goes far beyond barbecues and mattress sales. The holiday began after the Civil War, and at that time was known as a Decoration Day. While it was originally founded to honor the soldiers who died in Civil War. Since 1971, Memorial Day is a day of honor of all Americans who have died in military service. Patriotic Americans should take a moment from their day of celebration and leisure to reflect on the brave sacrifices of those who have given their lives for this great nation. I'd also like to read a short poem to you. It's okay. Remember those who served before. Remember those who serve no more. Remember those who serve today. Remember them all on Memorial Day. Also, Memorial Day is a day like any other. Since 1868, we have come together in our communities, towns and villages, to place flowers and flags on the graves of those who have given their last measure of devotion to our country. We have come here to remember and honor those who have done their duty as God has allowed them to see that duty. Those Americans who died in all these wars, and more could be mentioned, did their duty, and we know who they are. We know their loved ones, their wives, and their mothers, and their children and their friends, who always shall always miss them. Every Memorial Day, I have the privilege of going down to Fort Logan, and I recite a poem that is so indicative of Memorial Day. And I would like to recite that poem to you today, and listen very carefully. This poem was written in the year of 1915. It was written by a lieutenant colonel in the British Medical Army. And he was sitting on the back of his truck in a cemetery in Belgium. And he sat there and he wrote a poem as he was looking out over the graves. Please listen carefully. In Flanders fields, the poppies blow between the crosses, row on row, that mark our place. And in the sky, the lark still bravely singing fly. Scarcely heard amongst the guns below, we are the dead. Short days ago, we lived, felt dawn, saw sunset glow, loved and were loved, and now we lie in Flanders fields. Take up your quarrel with the foe. To you, with failing hands, we throw the torch. Be yours to hold it high. If ye break faith with us who die, we shall not sleep, though poppies grow in Flanders fields. I would like to take now the time to get Pete involved, and we're going to rededicate the memorial that you see in front of you. And again, it's a pleasure to be here to be able to speak to you. In October 1947, a dedication ceremony was at Lakewood Memorial Field at West 12th Avenue, which was directly behind the furthest west high school building on 10th and Wadsworth campus. Reverend Preston Childress of the Methodist Church and Wilbur Alter, Associate Justice of the Colorado Supreme Court, and Harry Graham, President of the Lakewood School Board, all Lakewood residents, spoke at the ceremonies. In conjunction with the October 1947 dedication ceremony, a memorial to 12 former Lakewood pupils who died in World War II was unveiled. Of Colorado granite, it was designed by Tony Bond of Wheat Ridge. We are here today to rededicate this World War II memorial to the new Lakewood High School. Thank you to those who lost their lives and their families that sacrificed so much in the defense of our grateful nation. We are here today to remember and rededicate our World War II memorial to our 12 fallen heroes, lest we forget. Thank you. We are now going to read the names and a little bit about each of the 12 that are inscribed on memorial behind us. And I've asked Pete to get involved with me. Do you want to do the first one or you want me
to? Sure, you can do the first one.
Okay.
Do we have any family members that are with Rags Addenbrook? Any family members? Please stand up and to be recognized.
Radcliffe Rags Addenbrook was killed in a plane crash on Guam. He was an electrician's mate, second class, United States Navy.
Thank you.
Next one's yours.
Ray Brandeman Jr., do we have any family members? Please raise your hand or stand to be recognized. Ray was killed in action 16 June 1944 and Sepan, buried in the National Memorial Cemetery of the Pacific, Honolulu, Hawaii. His rank was Private First Class, United States Marine Corps.
Next gentleman, Dale Broman, missing in action. His relatives are please standing. Let's give them a hand. He was missing in action the 13th of August, 1944. He disappeared on a bombing mission in the Pacific. He was a second lieutenant in the United States Air Corps. He received the Purple Heart Medal and the Air Medal.
Thank you. The next name is John B. Bray. Do we have any family members? John died 22 February 1946. Died as a result of vaccinations that were given at the time of the overseas deployment. His rank was PFC, Private First Class, United States Marine Corps. Thank you for your service.
Next gentleman, Donald Eugene Klein. Anyone here related to Donald Eugene Klein? He was killed in action while with the 7th Army in Europe. He was a staff sergeant in the United States Air Corps.
Would like to reach out to the family members that see our TV on Channel 8 and say thank you. The next one is John Andrew Dork. Do we have any family members? Please raise your hand or stand up to be recognized. John was killed in action 10 August 1943. He was lost at sea. He was a fireman first class, United States Navy. He received the Purple Heart American Campaign Medal, the World War II Victory Medal, and the Combat Action Ribbon. Thank you.
Next gentleman, Herman William Gerke. Killed in action. Any relatives here by chance? Gerke was killed in action the 15th of January, 1945, with the 1st Army Corps in the Battle of the Bulge. He was a private first class in the United States Infantry.
Next one is James B. Jellinson Jr. Do we have any friends or family members? Please raise your hand to be recognized. James was missing in action in 18 April 1943. He disappeared with the flying squadron over the Bermuda Triangle. His rank was second lieutenant, Army, United States Army Air Corps.
Next gentleman, Ernest D. Johnson, known as Danny. Interesting thing about Danny, I might say, is there any relatives or here? Oh, got one, stand up a second. Didn't see you, Art. This is Art Rittenhouse, president of the Lakewood Historical Society. He had his one of his childhood friends was Danny Johnson, so he has a very much close touch with him. Danny Johnson died approximately March of 1943 in a Utah Army camp in a training and a maneuver accident. He was a private E-1. He was assigned to the 7th Service Command, and again, he did die in Utah in a training camp.
Kenneth C. Mayberry, do we have any family members or close friends or friends? Please raise your hand or stand up to be recognized. Kenneth was killed in action in 30 January 1944 with the 2nd Infantry Division, the 7th Infantry Regiment, buried in Sicily, Rome. His rank was Sergeant E5, United States Army. He was awarded the Purple Heart, the Combat Infantry Men's Badge, American Campaign Medal, and the World War II Victory Medal.
The next gentleman on the monument is a gentleman named Robert Mulholm. He drowned in the Russian River in California with the United States Navy. No other information available about Robert Mulholm.
James D. Smith, do we have any family members or close friends? Thank you for coming. James died 29 October 1943. He was a Navy pilot in the United States Navy. He held the rank of ensign. He was out of Pearl Harbor Squadron JV-1. Died in a training accident in Florida. Thank you to all the family members.
Believe it or not, I have one more poem. I'm crazy about poems because I think they explain to us the inner parts of what our life is all about. This poem is called All Gave Some. This Memorial Day poem is sent with love to those who gave their ultimate all, our brave women and men, many of whom never came home again. This Memorial Day poem sees the shed tears, the broken bodies, shattered lives, eyes that can no longer shed any tears. Some give their all, but all gave some. This memorial remembers the values we hold freedom came by the way of shed blood and lives. Hear Reverend King call, I have a dream where all human beings can be equal and free. This Memorial Day poem sees those eyes through wide with terror. The heart was strong, pledged to God, family, and country. Some gave all, but all gave some. This Memorial Day, we are all of one heart. Freedom would be just a word we utter if their blood they had not willingly shed. Yes, they gave all, but all gave some. Thank you very much.
We'll have the benediction. First, I'd like to thank the members here of the Colorado Emerald Society Pipe Band. Can we have a big hand for these fellows? And also for, is the Lakewood Fire Department guy still here? You back there somewhere? There you go. If we could have a hand for those folks there. Of course, for Pete Roybal and Tom Keller for a wonderful, moving presentation. I have one more person to introduce. You know, there's a cliche that behind every good man there's a good woman, but I think you could apply that to what we have here today with our young Boy Scouts, and particularly with Austin. I'd like to introduce his mother, Annette Reynolds. She's right here. And I think you could say that behind every good Boy Scout, there's a great mother. She's been supporting him and with him all the way through, and we very much appreciate what you've done.
Thank you. Uh-huh. I'm very proud of him. Thank you all for coming.
So would you please stand for the benediction? Our Heavenly Father, let us never forget those who gave their lives for our country. Let us always encourage our young people to do all that they can in their lifetimes to help preserve the freedoms that our veterans have sacrificed for. Let us always encourage our young people to help others and to stand up for what is right. This we ask in your name, amen. And now we'll have the Boy Scout troop, we'll retire our colors.
Couple of songs first.
Okay. We're going to actually have the bagpipe fellows do a couple songs first, I understand. Is that correct? I'm getting a yes from over here and a maybe from over here. Please remain standing as the Boy Scout troop retires our colors.
Colors. present arms.